Hey, what's up, pointers? It's great to have you back with us tonight. Last week was an absolute blast. From the giveaways to the peep challenge to the new ways to greet video, it was just too much fun. And we've got an awesome night planned for you tonight as well. We're coming at you with a really great video about what it looks like to be stuck at home during quarantine. And then we're even trying out a junk food challenge that should be really interesting. But before we begin, make sure you hit us up on all the social media sites at PointStewMen to stay up to date with the latest post. We've got a new lineup for you throughout the week. Youth on Tuesday nights, main service on Wednesdays, and kids service on Thursdays, all premiering at 6:30 p.m. Lots of fun, lots of great content, and lots of ways to stay connected. And with that, let's get the show on the road. Welcome to Youth Night Live.
Hey, do you know what time it is?
Offering time?
Know what time it is?
Offering time!
It's giveaway time! If you watched the video last week, you know that we were giving away some awesome prizes. Do you know who those winners are?
Aubrey, Maddie, and Jasmine!
Woo-hoo! So they won some awesome iTunes cards. And if you want to win some new tunes to listen to while you're on lockdown, you know what you should do?
You should hit that bell, like, and subscribe.
Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely. I have nobody for my own. I'm so lonely. I'm Mr. Lonely. Wish I had someone to call on the phone. Now I'm a soldier, a lonely soldier, away from home, through no wish of my own. That's why I'm lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely. I wish that I could go back home. Letters, never a letter. I get no letters in the mail. I've been forgotten. Forgotten. Oh, how I wonder, how is it I fare? Now I'm a soldier, a lonely soldier, away from home, through no wish of my own. That's why I'm lonely. I'm Mr. Lonely. I wish that I could go back home.
Hey! We're so glad that you're with us tonight. No, but really, we are glad that you're with us tonight. And tonight we are going to be talking about being stuck. Have you ever found yourself in a sticky situation?
Yeah, that's exactly what we're talking about. I mean, people are stuck at home right now, literally.
Yeah.
You guys are stuck in front of your TV. Mm-hmm. You're stuck on your couch. You're stuck in your bedroom.
Yeah.
We can't go anywhere,
no,
man.
You can't this... go get your favorite sauna drink, your Taco Bell.
Yeah. This is the world's longest youth ministry lock-in right here.
Yeah.
And you're all locked into your own homes. Yeah. It's terrible. But talking about being stuck, I have this perfect story about being stuck. I was thinking about that this week. And a couple summers ago, we were out kayaking. We love to go kayaking in the summers when we can. And we went out to the Mulberry with a bunch of people. Were you and Colby there?
No, we weren't. We had gone a couple weeks after.
Okay, yeah, that's right.
And had a similar story.
Yeah, it just happens. Yeah. It happens. Something always happens whenever you're kayaking. And we're out on the Mulberry, and we come up to this kind of like fork in the river, and we see these guys in a canoe down the river, and they're stuck on this big old massive tree that had fallen across. There had been a storm a couple days before or
yes,
something.
And it rained so much.
Yes, yeah. You're supposed to check these things to see what's down the river, but we never do.
Yeah.
And so we see these guys down there, and they're telling us, they're waving like, go around, go to the other side. And so some of us went around the fork. Unfortunately, not all of us had the opportunity to do that. And so we go around the fork. We go the good way. Half of us guys, me and Slade, and I think Caleb did too. And so to go the other way, unfortunately, it kind of sucked you down the stream, right? And Lauren and Kenzie are both right there, and Hunter just decides, oh, I'm just going for it anyways. I'm going to go across the log. Who cares, right? And so Lauren and Kenzie weren't supposed to. We're yelling out, don't go that way, don't go that way. Well, a big old snake comes swimming for them, and they take off away from the snake, and they get sucked down that stream. And so they're on their way down the stream. Kenzie makes it fine, no problem. And then Lauren and Hunter, man, they got trapped on this log, and it was bad. It was so bad, it was sucking their kayaks underneath the log. And it got to the point where it wasn't
Were
just
they
like
underwater?
Yeah, so Hunter actually wound up going underneath the log. And he finally pops up at some point. It was crazy. His kayak goes underneath the log. And the problem was is that Lauren's got like stuck vertically on the log, and she was stuck on the log too. And she doesn't handle these kind of situations all that well anyways. And so we're around the corner. We can't hear anything going on. And all of a sudden, I just start hearing her start screaming, bloody murder.
Oh,
she's just screaming
God.
Like she's about to die. And it freaked me out. So we start paddling up the stream and realize, man, she's stuck. She is stuck on this massive log. And thankfully, Slade had gotten over there, and Hunter had gotten back up and was they're trying to pull her out, and thankfully, after a really long story and after her almost getting sucked underneath the log, they finally got her pulled up and out of the water, and it was a story that we will never forget.
Oh my gosh.
And
you'll
it made
never
us
go back.
No, seriously, the Mulberry is
like
definitely a place
again.
Like, okay, we are checking that before we go.
Yeah.
It was really scary, and I think we can all feel like we've been stuck at one time or another. Maybe not necessarily on a kayak, or maybe you're stuck at home right now on quarantine. It really just kind of stinks, to be honest, because you can't do anything.
Yeah.
You're stuck in a rut. And believe it or not, the Bible talks a lot about people being stuck. Mm-hmm. And you think about it, people that were stuck in prison like Paul, mm-hmm. or Jonah, who was stuck in the belly of a whale. Sometimes it's our own fault, and sometimes it's the fault of other people. People to be stuck there, right? But thankfully, we can trust in the fact that God is always there. God is there no matter what we're doing, whether we've caused us ourselves to be stuck there, or we've got stuck because of something else in our lives. So good or bad, we can turn to God because He's always there when we're stuck.
Yep.
Yeah.
Hi everyone. I'm Lena.
I'm Bailey,
and we are the Sad Seniors.
I'm Megan.
I'm Tatum, and we are the
Quarantine Queens. So today we're going to be taste testing a lot of junk food that has really weird flavors made, you know, and
we haven't seen it yet.
Yeah,
we don't
know, them.
Yeah. And we're blindfolded.
And we're going to have these in our mouths.
We're
going to
have the
while we eat it.
Speak out
really
mouthpieces. So we're going to look crazy. All right,
so
let's get started.
Let's go.
Alright.
Argon?
I got two as I
suggested.
I don't like this one. I don't like it.
I can't even taste it. It's just gone down my throat.
Lick the chip. I don't like that part.
Why are you
carrying it up the
Are you drooling?
I don't know. Are you drooling?
Put your hand on your mouth.
What do you think? Like,
yeah. Yeah, I definitely am.
If you're drooling, I'm asleep.
So the sad senior say pickle Pringle and
that's not pickle.
The quarantine queen say ranch. The real answer is honey mustard.
You're kidding me.
Megan, what? You can't see. What?
trying to keep on drooling because it's hot.
The seniors are saying baby food and fruit. And from the other team.
I know, the quarantine queens.
We've got banana, mango, and pineapple. Is that what you tasted?
Strawberry banana.
Yeah, we tasted banana for sure.
Strawberry banana.
We're going to give it a point to both of you.
Yeah!
No!
But who is closer?
Okay, take your blindfolds off.
Who is closer? Check out your flavors.
It looks good.
What was it?
Banana squash, mango pineapple.
I hate y'all.
She had chicken casserole!
Y'all, she literally spit everything.
Round four.
It was a cricket, it wasn't very good.
Mm-hmm. So. I regret squirting all the baby food into my hand. But I'm the one who made the least mess out of all three of us, so.
I was next.
The Oreos were really good.
I like
the Oreos. Mm-hmm. I didn't expect it.
Oh, the carrot cake one. Mm-hmm. So, even though we act like stupid idiots and ate really gross stuff, mm-hmm. The people who made us eat these gross stuff are up next, so check that out.
Hey, sometimes we do get stuck and didn't even do anything to cause it. Sometimes things like that just happen, but what matters is the way that we wind up responding to it.
Yeah, exactly, and that reminds me of a story in the Bible about Joseph. And we've probably all heard about this story, how Joseph gets sold into slavery by his brothers. There was some harsh relationship there, and he gets sold into this home. And the owner's name was Potiphar. And Potiphar had a wife, okay? So Joseph's working along, he's doing really well. Potiphar promotes him into head of the household for his farm or ranch or house or, you know, whatever, right?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
So promotes him. And then, but Joseph knew the one thing, and Potiphar had told him the one thing that was off limits was his wife, naturally, right? So the wife had a problem, though, I guess you could say, and she wanted Joseph to herself. So she comes up with this plan and this idea, and she ends up tricking Joseph to like come over or whatever. Well, Joseph didn't, and she ends up turning it around on him. So Joseph is in trouble this point. Okay. So he is in trouble, and Potiphar is upset like any husband
would be. Yeah.
Because he didn't know that his wife lied about the situation.
Uh-oh.
So Joseph gets thrown into prison, okay? Joseph is once again in the bottom of the pit in a prison. So you could only imagine what he feels like at this point in his life. Yeah. Like, here I am again. What have I done to deserve this? I didn't even do it. And maybe that's what you feel like even now. Maybe you're a senior and none of your stuff is getting done.
For real.
You're not getting to do prom. You're not getting to graduate. And you feel like, what have I done to deserve this?
Yeah.
Well, just like Joseph, God sees exactly where you are. He knows where you are. And that's what Joseph found out was he ended up becoming really good friends with the prison warden.
Yeah.
And God saw him. God knew what he was doing. And through the turn of events, Joseph ended up in Pharaoh's house, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Pharaoh's house. And so, but through that, he had to learn and he had to realize that God had something else in store and that he was with him even there, even in that pit, even in that prison.
Yeah, I think it's so important to understand that no matter where you are, if you do feel lonely or you do feel isolated, that God cares about you. God cares where you are.
Yeah.
And you might not understand how you got there. You might not even know why you're there. God still cares about it. He cares about your feelings. He cares about the emotions that you're going through right now. So although you might not be getting to do all the things that you want to be doing this year, you might not be getting to do those things that you've worked your whole life for. Yeah. Trust me and believe me, although it might not feel like it right now, although you might feel like you're in a prison like Joseph was, God cares where you are. And that's the thing that I think that we should all take away from this today.
Sure.
God cares where you are.
Yep.
Hey, have you heard about that new TikTok trend?
Which one?
The one with all the snapping.
Oh yeah, how do you play it?
Well, it's called Snaps is the name of the game.
But pictures are the way you play it. So snap a picture of you and your family watching this YouTube video right now.
Then DM it to us on Instagram for a chance to win a prize.
Whoop whoop. So we're about to do that right now.
Like you are stuck right now, but it is important to remember that you aren't, that God is with you, and that He wants you to be free from whatever you may feel stuck in.
Yeah, no matter what it is, if you're going through some difficulties at home or you were stuck in some stuff at school, it doesn't matter what it is, God is with you every single step of the way. Just like He was with Joseph in prison, He was with Jonah in the belly of a whale. There's another guy in the New Testament named Paul that wound up being in prison because he was proclaiming the word of God. And he finds himself in prison, and yet he encourages us and he encourages himself with these incredible words that we find in Romans chapter number 8. It says this, it says, "And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today or our worries about tomorrow." I love that part.
Yeah.
"Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below. Indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord." Man, this crazy global pandemic that we're going through, this quarantine right now might have you separated from your friends. You might not be able to see them at school. You might not be around your coworkers at your job, and you feel like you're all alone. I am so excited about the fact that in spite of all of that, God is still there with us. Not even a global disaster can keep you away from God. And it doesn't matter what you're going through today.
Yeah.
You might be facing situations just like that, or it might feel like it's an emotional drain. You might feel like you're emotionally stuck and you just can't get past this emotion or that depression or the difficulty that you're going in. You might feel like you're stuck in a relationship right now and you just can't break up with your boyfriend or your girlfriend right now.
Yeah.
No matter where you are, God is there with you and He will give you the strength.
Yeah.
When you can't do it on your own, I'm excited that God will be there with us and He helps us through it every single step of the way.
Yeah, and that kind of reminds me of, like, just thinking about it is that maybe this is God's way, like this global pandemic, like I don't think that He wished it upon His people or wished it upon us, but I think He can use it to benefit you.
Yeah.
He can use it to bring something good. He works together all things for the good of those called according to His will and His purpose. And so maybe you were going through something at school, you had friend issues, you were being influenced by wrong people. Maybe this is His way of being like, hey, I want to help you out on this, and I'm giving you some time just with me.
Yeah.
And so
that's great. That's great. He's with you, man. The Bible says He never leaves you nor forsakes you. He doesn't forget about you. He doesn't turn His back on you.
Yeah.
God is all caring and He's all knowing. He's all loving. He loves you and He is there with you every single step of the way.
Yeah.
Nothing in this world can separate us from the love of Jesus Christ. Man, that's why He went to the cross.
Yeah.
That's why we do what we do.
Yeah.
That's why we're sitting here having this conversation with you tonight, is because Jesus loved you enough to die on the cross for your sins. And you might feel like you're stuck at home tonight. You might not feel like you can get out of it. Maybe you're stuck in a rut, or you feel like you're stuck in quicksand tonight. Listen to me. Jesus is reaching out to you tonight to pull you out, to bring you to safety, to help you and help you understand that He loves you and He cares about you. And if that's you tonight, if you feel like you're stuck, I want you to do a couple things. We're going to pray for you in just a second, but first of all, I want you to take a second tonight and drop us a DM. Send us a message and let us know, hey, here's how you can pray with me. This is what's going on in my life. This is what God spoke to me through this video tonight. And we would love to reach out with you and pray for you personally.
Yeah,
and then not only that, after this video is over, take some time, pause it, and just spend alone with God and just pray to Him and ask Him to help you out of this situation. And I promise you, He won't leave you where you are. God loves you enough to take you from where you are to where you want to be. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thanks so much for being here with us tonight. We'll see you next week. So this last week we gave you a link down in the description of our video to a Bible plan that we did through this past week about the Shema. And the thing that I loved about it is that it gave a video for every day, and you got to watch and see kind of how they broke down one particular scripture. Every day was the same scripture, but you got to watch the video how they broke down individual words in it. And so I'm really excited about what we have for you tonight.
Yeah. So if you didn't get to do it last week, or maybe you forgot, you should definitely check it out. But we're going to be doing one this week called Stuck in Reverse, and it's a 10-day plan, and it just kind of goes over like kind of what we talked about tonight, feeling stuck and how to find hope and like an abundant life out of that.
Yeah, so. I love it. So click on the link in the description. It'll take you to the plan on your app. If you don't have the Bible app, you need to download it. But when you click it, it'll pop it up and you can start the plan. So definitely go do that.
Hey, Lena, what are you up to?
I'm reading the Bible plan that Pastor Cody was telling us about.
Oh yeah, is it good?
Yeah, it's actually really cool.
That's really cool. You know what else is really cool?
What?
Winning prizes.
That is so true.
This is actually your last chance to enter to win a prize tonight. All you have to do is share and tag this video.
Oh my goodness, let's do it right now.
Hey, I think we've all felt stuck at some point or another in all of our lives. Whether it was in a kayak or in a relationship or being grounded or stuck at home during a global pandemic, it's so reassuring to know that God is right there with us. He knows exactly where you are and He's there every step of the way. Just like that new song, The Blessing, says, He goes before us and behind us and He's beside us. And so take some time this next week. Thank God for being there with you in the middle of you being stuck. But before I go, let me pray for you tonight, all right? Lord, thank you for today. Thank you for these students. Thank you for every person that's watching this live stream tonight. I pray that you would help them to know and be encouraged by the fact that you are with them and that you care. God, thank you for that reassurance tonight. We love you and we thank you. In your name we pray, amen and amen. Pray that you have an awesome week. We'll see you back here next Tuesday.